Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Students, welcome back for our lesson today. Our discussion will be based on the Islamic dressing code, the guidelines on how we are supposed to put on our clothes, which kind of clothes we are allowed to put on, what is haram for us to put on. By the end of the lesson, the discussion, we'll be able to explain the characteristics of the Islamic dressing code for both men and women. We have general guidelines, and there are some guidelines that are specific for gender, either male or female. This is known, there are some common dresses for Muslims. If you look at this lady, she's well dressed. That is how a Muslim lady is supposed to appear. If you look at that man down there, he's well dressed, very handsome man, very beautiful lady. That is how actually a Muslim is supposed to appear. But we have to know that Islamic clothing is interpreted as being in accordance with the teachings of Islam. A Muslim knows very well that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered him to wear decently. Now that decency, that word decency, needs to be explained well. You can only explain the word decency through the Holy Quran and Hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, Muslims, it is known that Muslims wear a wide variety of clothing. It is normally influenced by religion. If you are a very religious person, there's a cloth that when you put, even psychologically, if you put on a kanzu, for instance, you put a kanzu, you put on a cape, it doesn't mean, it does not make you a better Muslim than the other one, but psychologically you feel you have fulfilled your obligation as far as dressing is concerned. And there are some people who are influenced by their culture, that when they put certain kind of dresses, they feel that now they are better off than any other person. Or maybe the work you do, if you're a sports person, there are some attire that you put on for sports. It does not take you out of Islam. There are some dresses we put on for cultural for social purposes. You put on some dresses because you want to look alike. You're going to parliament, for instance. Last week we saw some the parliamentarians put on some ties that look like resemble. Those are some of the things we're talking about. Political factors. You put on a t-shirt just to display the colors of a certain political party. Therefore, dressing code in Islam has actually been influenced, but interfered by so many factors. Culturally, there are some tribes, regions that have their own dress. That when you see this person, you will know this one is a member of this tribe. Let's say, for instance, we have like Nigerians. These are close, even whether you are a Nigerian or not. If you are still dressing this kind of dress, then they say this one is a Nigerian. Somalis have their own dress as well. As you can see there, the Somali ladies, you know how you call them. I may not know the names of these dresses. We have the Indians have their own dress also. Whether you are an Indian or not, if you put on this kind of cloth, they will know this one is an Indian dress. The Swahilis also have theirs. Now, there are so many other communities that have formulated their own type of dresses. Now, in modern times, some Muslims have adapted clothes that based on the Western tradition. The Western culture have their own way, mode of dress. As Muslims, some of us have also adapted. Like, for example, as you can see, somebody is having a suit, a And we have Muslims who put on suits, ties. Yeah. This one does not actually show that you have gone out of, you have gone out of Islam. And the majority of us wear trousers and shirts. All these ones were imported from the Western culture. Now, don't forget also the weather. The weather also determines which kind of cloth you will put on. For example, in a hot weather condition, we expect you to put loose-fitting clothing. That is very, very common. While in a cold weather, you will put heavy dresses so that you can be able to protect yourself from. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran. Allah says, وَاللَّهُ جَعْلَ لَكُمْ مِمَّا خَلَقَ ذِلَالًا وَجَعْلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ أَكْنَانًا وَجَعْلَ لَكُمْ سَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمُ الْحَرَّ وَسَرَابِيلَ حِكْمُ بَعَثَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, in chapter 16, verse 81, that Allah has made shade for you. Allah has also made so that you can have refuge. But our main point here is about the garments, that Allah has made garments for us so that we can protect ourselves from heat and also cold. Therefore, sometimes also we use clothes to protect ourselves from violence. If you are at war, there are some clothes that we could put on so that when we are hit, we don't feel pains. And even there are some clothes that we put on when you are driving, for instance, you are riding a motorcycle, you put on a helmet. Objective is, in case of any accident, you protect yourself. In other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains clearly in the surah that the clothes are meant for various purposes. Therefore, the weather can also determine which kind of clothes you're going to put on. However, we have to note one thing, that in all the conditions that you find yourself in, the Islamic dress must conform to the teachings of the Holy Quran and Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says in the Surah Al-A'raf, verse 31, that in this surah, Ya Bani Adam, خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا. Okay, the most important part we are looking for is the first part that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all you children of Adam, wear your beautiful clothes at every time, and when you go for prayers, you wear beautiful clothes. Now this beauty is the way you decide it yourself. There's some clothes when you put on, you feel that I'm very, very beautiful. That is what you have done. But you have to do through certain guidelines that we shall discuss in our next part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, Ya Bani Adam, kad anzalna alaykum libasan yuwari sawatikum wa risha wa libasu taqwa dhalika khayr. ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذْكَرُونَ. Allah says in this surah, or in this verse, all children of Adam, we have bestowed upon you clothing to conceal your private parts, and also adornment, so that you can also decorate yourself. You have to know that this one is the right thing for you to do. Now, you find that Allah has given us this as a blessing. And all the time, you have to thank Allah for all the blessings that He has given you. What do? You have to follow the guidelines. Those clothes that God has created to take care of you, you have to thank Him for that. And how do you thank Him? By following the guidelines on how you are supposed to use those clothes. In our next part, we shall look at those guidelines. Which kind of guidance that the Prophet has given us on the dressing code. This part Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Let's meet in the second part of this lesson.